ScavengerForest.com.
Hi students, all of you must have gone through the buffer solution theory session. Now we are going to do some questions based upon the buffer solution. This session is very basic session, level 1 session. Okay, so I have selected some easy questions so that your concept should be clear when you face the actual examination question. So to bring up your confidence to the entrance examination level, especially current scenario level, these questions are acts like a bridge between the concept you learned in the theory session and examination questions which you are going to face them. So after this we will have a level 2 session on the buffer solution, because buffer is a very very important topic and difficult topic. People are unable to identify even when this concept is to be used, in which way you have to apply. Okay, so let's start without delay. Let's start with the session. Buffer solution question session level 1. Are you ready? Okay, here is the first question. Dissociation constant of weak acid and monoproteic acid HX. Okay, its dissociation constant is given. Dissociation constant means it is Ka. What it is? Ka is given and a buffer is made by the weak acid, salt of the weak acid with strong base. This is the salt of with weak acid. That means it is an acidic buffer. Okay. So, can be best used to maintain pH in the range of, the best pH range you have to identify. Four options are given. So, I think you can try. If you don't, you can pause the video and try and then check with my explanation. Okay. So, try it, then I am explaining. Okay. Now, in the theory session, I told you the pH range. Of buffer, pH range of buffer is equal to pKa plus or minus 1. Okay, so here pKa, that means negative log of 10 to the power of minus 5. It is going to be how much? 5. This is Ka. Okay, Ka is given, so pKa is equal to negative log of Ka. So negative log of 10 to the power of 5 minus 5, you are getting 5. Okay. So, once you get 5, so this can be 5 plus or minus 1, that means 4 to 6. So, 4 to 6 means option D is correct. Okay. So, the buffer working range is pKa plus or minus 1. Okay. So, note down this question and with explanation, because this time you may feel silly, but when you complete the other chapters and other topics of even this chapter also, that time you may not remember the reason. So write the question with the answer along with the proper explanation. Think about the revision time mood. At this time, one topic, one question, it is easy. But during the revision, you may not recollect what it was explained that time. Okay? So instead of coming back and watching this video again and again, it may not be possible. So maintain proper notes. Okay, there is another question. A physician wishes to prepare a buffer solution at pH equal to 3.58. The pH of that buffer must be what? 3.58. That efficiently resist. Okay. So, buffer capacity will depend upon the pH range. Okay. And the best, he want that this weak acid, okay, then you should select a weak acid. That weak acid and sodium salt. Weak acid and sodium salt should give you the best result. Okay, so actually if we suppose this is the pH, okay, so this range will be the best use will be at this place, okay, and this will be pKa plus minus 1, this will be pKa plus 1, okay. So this, when this pKa is exactly equal to pH, okay, when pKa of the weak acid exactly equal to pH, that time the efficiency is highest. Is it understood? This is pH, this is also pKa. So that efficiency will keep on decreases and almost become zero as we move away from this point. Okay. So because of this best word and efficiently resist this pH, we can, if it is possible, we will check for the pH and pKa should match. See, this is matching. Therefore, this is the correct option. Okay. Highest efficiency when pH is equal to pKa. That means maximum buffer capacity. You add any amount of the acid, any amount of the base at this place, that efficiency will be highest. Okay. So that's why, what is the answer? D option. Note down this. Okay, here this question you can do it tactically, otherwise you will take more time for solution. Okay, I will tell you. See, this is the salt and ammonium hydroxide. See carefully. See, pKa is given. Okay, but it is a base. Okay, so you can do it after subtracting also. What you can do it? After subtracting also. But question is about the pH, so you can use as a pH directly formula. Okay. pH is equal to pKa plus log of C. One more twist is here, 0.02 and 0.01. Its equivalent factor is how much? 2. Okay. So this will be 0.02 divided by 0.01 into 2. Okay. Why? Because we have to convert into the number of moles of salt. This will give you the number of moles of NH4 positive. Okay, this is the base. Understood? Base is how much? 0.02. Okay, and salt concentration, out of the salt concentration we require about the ammonia. So 2 into 0.01. Okay, and this one will get cancelled. So answer will be pH is equal to pKa. Okay, so pKa is already given, 9.26. Suppose if he is about the pOH, then you should convert into pKb. How to convert? Very good. Okay, that time pKb will be like this, because pKa plus pKb is equal to 14. Okay, so all confusing answers. Understood? See, plus, minus, without plus, and 4.74 log 2. So this is not much about the simplification. It is about the presence of mind. If your presence of mind is there, then definitely you are going to answer this type of questions. Otherwise, see, up to here, you should avoid all the traps. Okay? Note down. Okay, next question. Addition of sodium acetate to acetic acid solution. See, sodium acetate is a salt of this weak acid with strong base. And this is a weak acid. So definitely what it is going to form? Buffer it is going to form. So pH is equal to pKa plus log of concentration of salt by it is acid. This is the formula, Henderson equation. And this concept already I have explained in the theory session also. Okay. So just for the revision purpose I am doing this. So if you are adding the salt, that means this concentration is increasing. Okay, so this is plus and this numerator is increasing, therefore pH will increase. So increase in pH. Is it understood? Note down along with the proper explanation. Take time now, don't worry about the time, because this is the time you have much more time to note down. Understood? But before division you will not get much more time like this. Okay, now slowly we are improving our level of questions. Okay, so in this one, this aminomethane, is mixed with HCl. This is weak base and it is strong acid. So is it a buffer question? No, we cannot decide now whether it is a buffer question or not. Okay. For buffer, it should be weak base and salt or weak acid and salt. Okay. So how to decide whether it is a buffer question or simple question? I will tell you the process. Okay. This process is very, very important because nowhere here it is mentioned about the buffer. That is the beauty of this question. Okay. So listen very carefully. First, CH3NH2 is treated with HCl. So base plus acid, what it will form? Salt. Okay. So CH3NH, it will become NH3 positive Cl minus. Understood? So initially we have taken 0.1 mole of this mixed with 0.08 moles. That will be zero. This is what initial. Okay. Now after this, we can write this as a 0.10. So after the process, this will be 0.02 mole left over. This will be zero and this will be 0.08 mole formed. Okay. So final, this is what final. Understood? Finally, we are left with salt and we are left with weak base. Okay. So weak base, along with the weak base, salt is there. Salt of the same weak base but with strong acid. Now is it understood? We have to apply which formula? Buffer solution formula. Okay. So I am writing the KB here. KB is equal to 5 into 10 to the power of minus 4. KB is equal to how much? 5 into 10 to the power of minus 4 is the KB value. Okay. So by using this and this you are going to solve for POH, then you will find out OH, then you will find out H plus. Okay, that is a big process. Understood? First what you will find out? POH. Okay. So I will tell you how to find out POH. POH is equal to PKB plus log of salt upon base. Okay, this is the concentration, PKB. Okay, PKB will be 4 minus log 5. Okay, I apply directly and plus log of concentration of salt will be 0.08 divided by 1 liter. So, you need not to write that 0.08 divided by 0.02. Okay, now this is not final answer. So from POH what you will find out? PH. From PH what you will find out? Concentration of H plus. Okay. So is this process clear? Note down this. Okay, noted. So this type of questions difficult to understand. Okay, first thing, which formula you have to apply. Second thing, so much of calculations. Okay, so from this POH, PH and H plus, if these type of questions will you find in the examination, you can do it at the last. Okay, because these are time consuming and risk taking. In this question, option B is correct. Okay, what answer you will get? Option B, 8 into 10 to the power of what will be the answer? 8 into 10 to the power of minus 11 molarity you will get after complete simplification. Okay. So, strategy, is it understood? These type of questions need to be answered only at the final stage. Okay. Because of in the time you are spending on this question, you can spend and solve 2 to 3 questions from the other chapters or theory question from other subject also. Okay. So that's why scoring is very important, strategy during the examination is very important. Okay. Okay, next question is volume of 10 ml. Okay. 10 ml of strong acid. Strong acid with pH is equal to 2. pH 2 means 10 to the power of minus 2 molarity. And 10 ml added with 990 ml of buffer. Okay. With pH is equal to 4. Buffer pH is 4. Acid pH is 2. Okay. this is 10 ml, this is 990 ml. Then pH of that mixture will be, okay. So normally people will solve, but as a student of VegChem, you need not to solve, okay. I will tell you the trick, okay. How simply pH, if you, if you add acid to any buffer solution or any solution, addition of acid, in the very starting I told you, addition of acid, pH should decrease. So already pH is 4, so this is more than 4, this is more than 4, this is more than 4, okay. And you can see here, small amount of acid added to large amount of base, sorry, buffer. Therefore, buffer capacity is maximum and there is no change in the pH. That's why, what is answer? D answer. If suppose anywhere option is 3.992, so without calculation, blindly go for that, because slight decrease will be there in the pH. On addition of acid, pH will decrease. Is it understood? So what is the correct answer? D. This is how the strategy you have to apply. These are all techniques you don't find in the books. Okay. So this is how the people solve and their experience will gain. Understood? So that experience will be transferred to the students. That's why selecting a good mentor is very, very important. Understood? See you. Bye bye. I think all of you have given a like to this video. If not done, at least for these two wonderful techniques, you should give a like and share to your friends who are worried about the physical chemistry, or chemistry is a mystery to them, so that they can also get crazy. Okay?